Hi. I was asked by one of the subscribers about a problem in the loft tool, and that is when you select editable splines, objects or shapes with edit spline modifier. If you choose those as cross sections for the loft tool, they are invisible in the loft object. So now we will try to reproduce this issue and see how we can deal with that. I will select the path and then click loft. This problem happens when you choose editable splines objects or shapes with edit spline objects as cross sections, and at the same time you are using the instance option. If you are using the copy option, this will not happen. Of course, with the shapes that are primitives like circles, rectangles, you don't have any problem with that if you use instance or copy. So now I will click this shape here at the position zero, and we will get this loft. I will put 50% and pick this shape. I'm using the instance. Now you can see that if I go to shapes of object level, I can still select those cross sections you can see here and manipulate them, but they don't turn red. I don't see them. As you know, probably the benefit of using the instance is that I can go back to the original shape here and manipulate it from here. If I choose the, I will use this editable spline as a third cross section. I will choose 90%. This time I will choose copy. As you can see with copy, you can see that it turns green here because with the loft objects, when you select a loft object. The last chosen cross section shows as green, and if I go to shape, if I select it, it will turn red. So in case of choosing, when we choose copy, we don't have this issue. So, but with the copy thing, if I go to the original shape and try to manipulate it, I don't see any effect here. But what I can do, I can go to shape, select the cross section, and as you can see, I will see it here. I can go to vertex, for example, or segment, or whatever, and I can manipulate the cross section in place. So if you care too much about having this cross section visible, well, because you want to manipulate it from here, well then it's okay, you can still select it without seeing it here. But if you care about seeing it here, you can choose the copy option and manipulate it in place. Of course, with these here, I have two primitives. With primitives, I don't have this issue. I will choose 30% and pick shape. In both cases, if I choose 10% and copy. So with primitives, I have no issue, but when I have the editable spline or edit an object with edit spline modifier, I will have this problem, or well, it's not a big problem, but this small issue if I choose the instance option. Now there is a little trick you can use for both editable splines or primitives. If you like to see the location clearly on the loft object, for example, this one that I've chosen for the zero position, you can choose the option enable in viewport, as you can see here, and you can give it a small thickness. This way you can see it here on the object. I will choose the same one for let's say the 75%. Here, as you can see, you can choose a small amount. Be careful, just use enable in viewport. Don't enable the renderer option here, because you don't want to see it inside. You don't want it to render with your object. So basically, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something. And if you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time. Thank you.